Good morning. How may I help you?
We've an appointment with Baron de Mont.
I'm sorry, but are you sure it was today? The Baron usually reserves Mondays for golf. Tuesdays and Thursdays are for skeet shooting, Wednesdays for fishing, and Friday afternoons for backgammon.
Sounds like a busy schedule. How does he find time for appointments?
His lordship reserves Friday mornings between 11 and 11:15 a.m. for business matters.
Well, I'm positive today was the day.
Could you take another look at the appointment book?
I suppose, but I can't see that it will do any good. The Baron's routine is quite established. Would you excuse me for a moment?
That should keep her busy for about 10 minutes, poor lass.
All right, wait here just in case. I'll find the Baron's office and see if I can dig up some incriminating evidence.
I've got a better idea. You wait here and I'll snoop around.
No way, Sugar Pie. Remember what happened last time?
Heads or tails?
Tails.
Heads. You lose. Sugar Pie.
2 out of 3?
Don't be a sore loser.
Fine, but stay sharp. If you're seen, the mission's blown. If the Baron figures out you were in his office, the mission's blown. If you hurt anybody...
The mission's blown, I know.
Just remember what I said.
I'm not sure I agree with
you. Did you see what she did with her hair? It's horrible.
Yes, Mr. Hilltop.
That's what Melanie was just saying.
Certainly, Mr. Hilltop. Just drag me into his drawer. Here it is.
Ah, oh, good, good. You look very nice today.
Thank you, Mr. Hilltop.
I'll be in my office if anybody calls for me.
Yes, sir.
Sorry to hear that, sir.
Somebody's certainly going to be sorry. Get hold of Mr. Manning for me, would you, dear? Thank you, Evelyn. Manning, this is Hilltop,
the Beatles?
Sure.
I wish they'd go on tour again.
Don't hold your breath.
Well, as long as they keep making records, I'm happy. I just hope they don't break up.
Hey!
Any luck?
Plenty. Do you trust me now?
Nope.
Now then, let's see if, we can't sort this confusion out, shall we?
That's all right. Perhaps we can reschedule at a more convenient time.
Certainly. How about Friday at 11 a.m.?
Perfect. See you then. I want to take a look around in there.
Good idea, but it's my turn.
Heads or tails?
Uh-uh. You got to go last time.
Heads or tails?
I'm going, you're staying. No arguments, no coin toss.
Don't be such a Jesse. Heads or tails?
Heads.
Tails. You lose. Again.
I'm in charge here. I give the orders, you take the orders.
Well, now that we've decided who's going in, what are your orders, sir?
All right. I'll help you get inside, but you'd better be careful. If anyone sees you, liquidate him before we can set off an alarm, and stay clear of security cameras.
Don't worry.
Photograph anything that looks suspicious and collect as much intelligence as you can. Files, correspondence, dossiers, anything.
Aye, aye, sir. Excellent orders, sir. I look forward to following them.
Give me a few seconds head start.
Was it any good?
Something about this Venusian society.
Oh, I saw that one. It was kind of weird. But they're all pretty weird, if you ask me.
True.
That Diana Rigg is one fine specimen.
She sure is. I wouldn't mind getting roughed up by her.
Faulty pump like I asked you to?
Yeah.
Then perhaps you know why it's not working.
You, didn't see my report?
No, I did not.
I put it on your desk yesterday.
Did you? And what exactly did your report say?
That the pump needed to be replaced.
Why didn't you replace it?
You asked me to inspect it and file a report.
Did I?
I'm fairly sure.
Perhaps you'd care to accompany me back to my office and help me locate this report of yours.
I'm supposed to go on patrol.
Then stop by as soon as your shift is over.
Yes, sir.
planes, will you?
Yes, sir.
And see if you can find out who turned it on and haul the bastard into my office. I'm a bit tense today. Knocking the teeth out of some thick-headed sword sounds like just the ticket.
Sure thing, sir.
okay? You seem kind of down.
Just stressed.
What's wrong?
My mother-in-law's coming into town this weekend.
You don't get along with her?
Actually, it's neutral.
How long is she here for?
A month.
Oh my God!
Hello, what have we here? Sergeant Magnus Armstrong. Well, well. It was Armstrong, all right. I'm sure of it.
Excellent work, Archer.
What do you want us to do now?
Try to interview the Baron at his estate. We need to know if he's involved.
You think it might be someone within the organization?
I'm hoping that you and Goodman can answer that question.
Aye, sir. We'll do our best.
Let's go.
Tails.
Heads.
Damn it!
Ah, don't pout. Your eyes get all small and piggy when you're sulking.
How are you planning on getting in there anyway?
I'll charm my way in.
Well, I hope you brought some secret charm powder or something, otherwise you're in big trouble.
I've got better weapons in mind.
Like what?
You've been staring at them all afternoon.
Huh?
Yes?
Good afternoon. My name is Mia Hegg. I'm from Men of Influence magazine.
Men of Influence? What on earth are you doing here?
This is the residence of Baron Archibald Dumas, is it not?
Yes.
Baron Dumas certainly seems to qualify as a man of influence, wouldn't you say?
I suppose it would depend on how you choose to define influence.
He is the president of Dumas Industrial Enterprises.
Ah.
He's wealthy.
True.
He's well respected.
Hmm.
He's dashing. He's debonair.
Listen, this is all very educational, but what exactly do you want?
I'd like to interview the Baron about the future of Dumas Industrial Enterprises. Our readers love stories about savvy businessmen conquering corporate challenges in our modern age.
Ah, yes. Sadly, the Baron does not disclose information regarding his business to anyone, even attractive young females such as yourself. So sorry.
I was hoping to profile Baron Dumas for a Perfect Lives series. Each month we cover a different person whose lifestyle and disposition exemplify perfect living.
And you wish to include his lordship in this series?
Yes. The idea is to penetrate the myth and get to know the man, his pastimes, his ambitions, his accomplishments, the things that make him tick.
I see.
He's a model aristocrat.
Ah.
Someone our readers can look up to.
Of course. Will you excuse me for a moment, Miss Hegg? I don't think I could forgive myself if I were to let this sublime opportunity pass by. I will discuss your request with his lordship and return presently with his answer.
Thank you.
Please, wait here. I shan't be a moment. Very well. His lordship has agreed to see you.
Excellent.
This should be amusing.
What do you mean?
Nothing. Follow me, please. Miss Hegg, sir.
Splendid. Show her in.
I'll leave you to your interview, darling. I'll be shopping for the rest of the afternoon.
Yes, yes. Have a marvelous time, Chipmunk.
Don't call me that.
As you wish, my love. Pip-pip.
He's rather larger than I expected.
Ah, yes. He's a big bundle of charisma and intelligence. If you're lucky, perhaps he'll regale you with his rousing safari adventures.
Good day, Baron Dumas.
Goodness, had I known you would be so sumptuous, I might have preened. Care for a drink?
No, thank you. It's a little early for me.
Well, I'll indulge for us both in that case. I hope you'll pardon me for saying so, but you're a ravishing girl. Simply ravishing.
That's very kind of you. I'm sure your wife feels absolutely spoiled by your abundant charm.
Oh, she's a lucky old crow, I'll grant you that. Now then, Giles tells me you want to profile me for this magazine of yours. Men of Influence, was it?
Yes. Each issue we cover a different person in our Perfect Lives series, someone whose lifestyle and achievements serve as inspiration for our readers.
Jolly good. You've come to the right place. That will be all, Giles.
Actually, sir, I thought it might be worthwhile for me to stay, in case the young lady should desire anything at all.
Splendid idea. Pip-pip.
Yes, sir. I'll be right over here if you require anything, Miss Haig.
Thank you. Baron Dumont, do you mind if I record our interview? I'd rather devote my attention to you than to my notepad.
And who could blame you? Record away, my dear. So then, where shall we begin?
What's it like being such a prestigious big game hunter?
Well, it's difficult to explain to someone who's never experienced the thrill of the hunt, you see. When it's you and your trusty blunderbuss all alone against a ferocious beast, you discover exactly what sort of stuff you're made of.
Sounds ghastly.
Oh, it takes a special breed of male, I'll grant you that. The merest hesitation could cost you a leg.
What's the most heroic thing you ever did on safari?
Splendid question. Well, I once wrestled a lion to the ground and strangled it to death with my bare hands. Yes, I remember now. My porter had injured his leg and was about to be mauled.
Dear Lord! Dear Lord, how courageous!
Yes, indeed.
Oh, one doesn't really stop to think about these things. One merely acts.
It's amazing you didn't come to harm.
Yes, well, the Dumas lineage is renowned for resourcefulness and fortitude.
I'm sure our loyal readers would love to know what hunting rifle such a magnificent sportsman favors on safari.
Ah, yes, indeed. Well, it depends to some degree on the beast I'm tracking. For a tiger, I tend to favor the legendary Matterhorn Model 4 Special Issue.
Isn't that a 22 caliber target rifle? Seems a bit feeble for a tiger.
Yes, but I savor a challenge.
How intrepid! You must be quite a marksman to take down a tiger with a single round from a 22.
Well, sometimes it takes a few more than that.
Still, even 3 rounds is impressive.
It's usually more like 17 or 18.
Really? You might find a larger caliber to be more humane.
Yes, but then you have to deal with all that nasty recoil.
I see. I noticed you have quite a collection of fine art about the place. Who are some of your favorite painters?
Oh, I like them all.
But surely there must be one or two whose work stands out for you.
Certainly. Phipstein is probably my favorite.
I'm not familiar with his work.
Not many people are. It's quite smashing. I'm sure you'd love it.
What movement?
Excuse me?
Is he an impressionist, surrealist, constructivist, pointillist?
Yeah, a little of everything, actually. He's quite versatile.
Really? Do you have any of his work about?
Normally, yes, but it's out being cleaned.
Cleaned?
Yes, those old paintings get so dusty.
Ah. Is there anything that can strike fear into the heart of such a stalwart hunter as yourself?
Frankly, no.
Really? Nothing at all?
Not that I can think of.
Not even centipedes?
Oh, dreadful things. Yes, I suppose, perhaps centipedes.
Personally, I'm terrified of rats.
God, yes. Those beady, evil little eyes and sharp little vermin teeth. Horrible animals, especially in a mob.
And spiders?
Oh, don't even mention them.
How did you become so courageous?
Oh, just something one's born with, I suppose.
I understand that yours is a steadfastly Episcopal lineage. How does your unswerving faith influence your day-to-day life?
This should be good.
Well, you see, faith is... how should I put it? Faith is... Oh, simply put, faith... I'm sure plenty of other great men have had keen things to say about faith. Why don't you be a dear and just quote one of them?
Smashing idea. Was that a gazelle trophy in the foyer?
Ah, yes. Beautiful creature, isn't it?
I'm sure it was lovely when it was alive. Aren't they quite fast?
Indeed.
You must be quite a marksman.
True, although I was rather close in this particular instance.
How close?
5 yards, I should think.
I'm impressed. Stalking a gazelle within 5 yards?
I didn't really stalk it, per se.
How did you get that close?
Well, it was in a pen, you see.
Pardon?
Some years ago, it occurred to me that all that traipsing about in the wilderness is a dreadful waste of time. I concluded that since what I really want is a handsome trophy to hang on my wall, why not simply put the beast in a pen out in the yard and shoot it there? Save myself the bother of tracking it all over creation.
Why not just buy trophies, then?
Some men might be satisfied with that sort of compromise, but I only display animals I've collected myself. There's no honor in buying a trophy now, is there?
How efficient. Is there a message you'd like to share with your many admirers?
Good hunting, my humble devotees.
Well, that's all the questions I prepared. I must confess, I'm positive this will be our most popular Perfect Lives installment yet.
Oh, you think so?
Absolutely. Rarely does nature combine so many excellent qualities in one man. Our readers will be fascinated, and maybe even a bit envious.
One can hardly blame them.
What I don't understand is where such a busy man finds the time to be a successful business tycoon, loving husband, daring hunter, astute philosopher, cultivated humorist, etc. Aren't you overwhelmed?
Well, one learns to delegate. For example, although you wouldn't guess it, I'm only peripherally involved with Dumas Enterprises these days, strictly in an advisory capacity, you see, to keep the company on track.
How ingenious.
Oh, well, I have my moments.
But isn't it an awful risk to hand over operations to someone less accomplished in the subtleties of enterprise than yourself?
Actually, it's safer that way.
Really?
Yes, you see, in my experience, the less one knows about running a business, the less he can screw up. I make all the important decisions. The rest is just, you know, paperwork.
Still, you wouldn't want your competitors getting their hands on that paperwork.
Oh, quite true. But we have a very large safe in which to store it.
Safes can be cracked.
No, not this one. Even if someone could get inside, he'd still have to get past the security system.
Sounds daunting.
Oh, it is. There are invisible beams.
Infrared?
Exactly! If you touch one of them, the doors lock and poison gas is released into the safe.
How terrible.
Oh, I'd like to meet the burglar who could get in there.
It would take a lunatic even to attempt it.
Or a fool.
Thank you for your time, Baron de Mor. It's been an eye-opening experience.
I'm happy to oblige. Never turn your back on a worthy cause, I always say.
A worthy meal is more like it. Well done!
Is it possible he was putting on an act?
I don't think so, sir. I'm fairly confident the man is an imbecile.
I heard the tape and I gotta agree.
Still, it's clear that Dumas Industrial Enterprises is somehow linked to harm.
Well, didn't the Baron say that he wasn't really running the show anyway? Who's the vice president of the company?
According to our research, his name is Damascus Valentine.
D.V.
What?
His initials, Damascus Valentine, Dmitry Volkov. Coincidence?
Seems rather tenuous.
But nonetheless intriguing. In any case, we need to know what's in the safe the Baron mentioned to you. It won't be easy, naturally, but it could be the key to this investigation.
I'm looking forward to the challenge, sir.
That's the spirit. Mr. Smith, what did intelligence find out about the building?
It's a veritable fortress. Not only is there a suspiciously large and well-trained security staff, but they've also invested heavily in high-tech surveillance equipment. Cameras, infrared alarm systems, the works.
They must really have something to hide.
Our thoughts exactly.
So what's the plan? Who is going inside?
You are.
What? Why her? It's way too dangerous for a woman.
Oh, don't start with that again.
Before joining Unity, Agent Archer was something of an expert in, covert infiltration, one might say.
Breaking and entering, others might say.
Whatever the case, this assignment calls for stealth and subtlety.
Yeah, I know. Subtlety isn't my specialty. I still think it's too dangerous for her to go in alone.
Which is why you'll be providing a distraction for her downstairs.
I like the sound of that.
How do I get inside?
Attempting entry on the ground floor would be suicide, even for an expert like Ms. Archer. The only way in is through the roof access.
What did you have in mind? Am I going to have to parachute in?
Too imprecise. Fortunately, there's an alternative. Dumas Enterprises is erecting a second skyscraper right next to its corporate headquarters. Our surveillance photos suggest that if you can get to the top of the new building, you can use a crane to cross over to the roof of the old one.
The surveillance photos suggest that this is possible?
It will be close. You'll have a zip code to cut the difference.
I see.
Once you're inside the building, you'll need to locate the president's office and find the safe. Photograph anything remotely suspicious.
We don't want to tip our hand, so leave everything as you found it. The less they know about our mission, the better. Now then, time is of the essence.
Yes, sir.
Welcome to Advanced Field Tactics. Here we have the Sphinx Series M code breaker. Simply attach it to a standard 10-key security pad, and it will run through a series of combinations until it breaks the code. The duration of this process is determined by the complexity of the code, so it may be advisable to hide until the procedure is complete. Try out your code breaker on this keypad. Added an infrared scanner to your sunglasses to help you circumvent the security systems you're likely to encounter. If you see suspicious-looking fixtures like these mounted on a wall, be sure to switch on your scanner lest you announce your presence unintentionally. Excellent.
I'm bored. I never have any fun. Neither do I.